you're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
All right, no matter how you plan to spend your holidays, there's always a little bit of time when stress sneaks into the picture.
Mm-hmm. So how did you avoid being the Grinch? Don't you love that song?
I know. Season.
Life coach Margie Worrell is here today with a look at how you can have a happy holiday. Hi, Margie. Of course we want to be happy this holiday.
Yeah. Yes.
No Grinches around.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think that when a lot of people look ahead to the holiday season, they start like feeling stressed.
It's well, you walk into the mall. Have you guys been to the mall lately?
Yes.
And they're setting up for Santa.
Uh-huh.
And maybe it's the right time. They do it each year, but I can't deal yet.
I know. It's like we have to brace ourselves. It's like, okay, here it comes. I'm ready for it or I'm not.
Right.
So I think it's really important to kind of go into the holiday season not expecting to be stressed out and have it be this period that you always kind of almost looking forward to getting out the other side of. But what is it about the way you're approaching it that makes it stressful, and what are some things you can do to simplify the holiday season so that it's not one of those crazy stressful times that you actually enjoy it?
Well, that's because it's not just the presents. That's just one thing.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's the cooking and the baking and the visiting and, you know, it goes on and on, the cards and the parties.
There's a long list of things, and I think that's what makes it stressful. You know, we feel we've got to, you know, get all the gifts happening and all the entertaining and the parties and the, you know, there's just so many things on that list that we want to have be just right. And I think it's the pressure we put on ourselves to have it all kind of conform to some Martha Stewart-like magazine cover image that everything's got to be perfect.
That's me. That's how I approach the season.
So I think sometimes just like lowering it and thinking, you know what, it doesn't have to be postcard perfect. It's going to be great, but it might not be postcard perfect.
Is it a matter of just like losing control, but just kind of giving up some of the control?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think it is. Giving up having to make it be a certain way. Also just taking that, I call it, you know, don't should on yourself. We have so many shoulds around the holiday season.
What did you just say? Should?
S-H-O-U-L-D. Let me just clarify if it's my accent.
You
know, my accent, sometimes people...
Okay, we got it. I'm kidding with you.
But we have all these shoulds. You know, I should be doing this, and I should be doing that, and I should be doing all my... You know, just like make it simple. What would allow you to enjoy it more? What's something that you could stop doing? What's something you could start doing?
You know, and the big thing that comes to mind is greeting cards. Because everybody, at least women, guys don't do this. They don't put this pressure on themselves. So I've become a guy, and I've stopped it with the pressure. Because, you know, you always think handwritten things are great, and they are, but you have that stack. Yeah. And you want to get it out to everybody. Yeah. And it's just, it becomes a horrible assignment.
And you can't just write your name on that.
You have feel like you need to write
a personal
like,
letter
Johnny
for each one of them.
This year,
right.
You know?
That to me is a perfect should. You know, do you want to do it or not? Be clear. You know, why are you doing it? Is this because I really want to do this? Or is it because I think I should and people might think I'm just really bad that I don't? Mm-hmm. And I think sometimes getting one in January can be nice because I get so many in the mail myself. I'm like, oh, okay, another one. You know, it can be like that. So really think about what's the reason I'm doing this? Is it because of social expectation? Or is this because it's something I really want to do? And there's ways we can let our friends and family know that we appreciate them and that we wish them well, besides, you know, the postcard that we stick in the mail that says season's greetings, you know, so.
Yeah, and we can also let our loved ones know how much we love them without the big expensive gift, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be that
way. I say think outside the box. The best gifts aren't the ones that cost the most money. They're the ones that have the most thought behind them. And, you know, I always say to my kids, don't go out and spend money, you know, because ultimately it's my money anyway. You know, I would rather get a voucher for a foot massage or breakfast in bed or,
right.
You know, but even with our friends, there's simple things we can do. We can organize to have them come over for a dinner or, you know, a picnic in the spring, or there's other things we can do besides buying expensive gifts.
You have to feel that you have to prove yourself to someone and think about what am I going to get them?
Yeah. Yeah. And I think when we're going into the present buying with that sort of like, oh my God, I've got 23 presents I have to get. This is going to be such a draggy weekend. Mm-hmm. Like, think about, is that the spirit you want to bring to the season?
But then people get caught up, especially at work or, you know, teachers, daycare, stuff like that. If you have kids, if he gets a gift or if I get a gift, I need to give a gift. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a lot more of it than just wanting to prove yourself and buy an expensive gift is, what if she gives me a gift and I don't have a gift?
Well, you know what? Because I have 4 kids, so we have so many teachers and so many people, I am going to this year, I've just made this decision, I'm going to go and have a day in the next couple of weeks where I just bake toffee and things and I'm going to wrap them all up in little cute little cellophane things, put a little note in there, something that's fun, and just have a whole lot of them.
That's
and just be giving them out.
Got it covered.
Got it covered.
Love things from
Make
your
30
own
or 40.
Kitchen.
And yes. It's from my own kitchen. It's not expensive. It'll be fun to do it with my kids. But it's the spirit, and I know people will appreciate just that simple gift.
Absolutely.
So there's things we can do just to keep it simple.
But you know, we all have these traditions, I guess, from mm-hmm. our childhood days, the mm-hmm. way our moms did things mm-hmm. or whatever, and we kind of want to bring that forward. But you know, it might be time to start some of your own traditions, right?
Yeah. I mean, there's traditions are lovely. There's many traditions are lovely, and there's a reason why we have them. But some traditions, they can become really burdensome, like trying to do it the way we've always done it.
Or like mom did it.
Sure. As our families go through different cycles and then we all have children, you know, things, it's like, okay, this doesn't work anymore. Let's come up with another tradition. Let's do Kris Kringle. We may never have done that before, but how about we do that this year with gift giving rather than trying to buy something for everyone? Let's pull a name out of a hat. So I think sometimes we have to challenge the traditions and say, is this tradition one that's enriching our family experience of the holiday season and my experience? Mm-hmm. Or is it actually just causing me stress and like, oh my gosh, I've got to do this because we've always done it that way.
My daughter actually even told me, she says, I don't even like the formal dinner parties. And why can't we just have the
did
food?
Did that
and
absolutely
just, like,
break your heart?
I sort of did.
She is like Sally Homemaker. Yes. You're wonderful at it. Seriously, everything that she does at home is wonderful.
No, but I mean, you know,
I'll come in her place.
You spend all those hours in the kitchen and then you want to present it in a beautiful setting.
Yeah.
But you know, it wasn't working for her. So I don't know whether that's something we'll keep her
in. And I think to think that it works for you and that's wonderful. But it doesn't work for her, you know. So I just think, just because someone else does it this way doesn't mean you have to do it mm-hmm. this way. Do what works for you. And don't feel like you have to conform.
But you know what I bet,
Mel,
in a couple years? Like, if you stop doing that, she'd probably be like, Mom. Because we do that to our moms, I think.
That's so true.
I think that'll
and
happen.
And there's no pleasing everybody, is there? Mm-mm.
No. What did Bill Cosby say? I don't know the key to success, but I know the key to failure is trying to please everyone. And I think that applies in the holiday season as well.
We got to give up.
I agree.
Just give up. I can
I'm
do
ready
that.
To dial it down. Absolutely, Margie.
Thanks for
some great
you.
Tips.
Thanks.